For the last 10 days, Donald Trump has been on a bit of a firing spree. He is actively removing inspectors general from several prominent positions inside his administration after these inspectors general, which, yes, that is how you would do the plural of that, and it just sounds weird. But anyway, after these inspectors general had either called out the Trump administration or released reports that kind of showed the administration was doing some things that might not quite be on the level. These include Intelligence Community Inspector General Michael Atkinson. He was the one who actually forwarded the whistleblower complaint to Congress. The whistleblower from the Ukraine story. He's the one who sent it to Congress after reviewing it and found it to be something that Congress would probably be interested in. Donald Trump fired him about a week ago from Friday. Then he publicly attacked, did not fire yet, but I imagine that one's on the horizon. Health and Human Services Inspector General Christy Grimm, after she published a report showing that the federal government's coronavirus response had been inadequate and had caused the crisis to intensify unnecessarily. And of course, we had the one we discussed earlier this week where he fired Glenn Fine. No explanation on that one. But what's happening, and now we actually have a bipartisan group of lawmakers in the Senate who are demanding answers on this. He is firing any and everyone who is in an oversight position. But not just in an oversight position, anyone who's in an oversight position who might be slightly critical of what Donald Trump is doing. Now, we saw something similar to this. Remember back in February, it was only 2 months ago, when he started firing lots of people who testified in the impeachment hearing. People who testified because they were subpoenaed. They had to testify. And they said things that Donald Trump wasn't quite thrilled about because they implicated him in criminal activity. So he started firing them once the entire episode had ended. He's doing the same right now, even though this particular crisis has not ended. It has not even leveled out yet. It's still increasing. The man is drunk with power, and he became drunk with power the day the Senate voted to acquit him of the impeachment charges. That's when this happened. Now, don't get me wrong, the man had always been slightly drunk with power since day one, but things have gotten worse. And during this time of international crisis, we need oversight now more than ever. We have seen the mismanagement coming from the federal government. Jared Kushner, for God's sakes, is in charge of doling out the supplies that FEMA is confiscating from hospitals. And as we can all tell, he's delivering it to states that praise Trump instead of the states who have been critical of Trump, who desperately need it. That's the kind of thing an inspector general would probably want to look into. And Trump is firing them. He is openly criticizing them on Twitter, during interviews, during press conferences, trying to discredit them so that he can lay the groundwork for firing them in the future if he hasn't already done it. Folks, this is bad. This is authoritarianism. And that's why it makes me even sadder to think the best thing the Democrats have to offer on the other side is Joe Biden. Donald Trump is at his weakest point right now. He feels he's at his strongest, but he's at his weakest. We didn't have to go with the so-called safe candidate who's not safe at all. We could have taken a big risk. We could have taken a big chance. But voters decided not to do that. And that's a shame. Because this man right now is doing everything in his power to give himself more power. And we need somebody who absolutely cannot screw this up and win this election. And I don't think that's what the Democrats are putting forward. So until then, we have to hope, we have to pray, we have to make sure, we have to make phone calls, we have to send emails, we have to tweet at them to let every member of Congress know that they have to demand oversight, they have to demand investigations into this, and they have to launch them themselves if that's what's necessary. Because this man thinks he's a dictator, yet if nobody holds his feet to the fire, then I guess he's right.